we participated in the 2024 Advanced Industrial Robotic Applications Challenge, where teams were tasked with creating a teleoperated robot system capable of industrial inspection tasks in a simulated chemical facility. The human operator was required to control the robot with only the robot's onboard sensors and no direct line of sight, simulating a situation where the robot is deep inside a chemical plant and the operator situated far away must take direct control of the robot to manage an unexpected situation. Five teams competed for a grand prize of 40,000 euros, and we won third place using the ALMA-legged manipulator robot. In the door opening task, the robot was required to open, go through, and close a door in both the pushing and pulling directions. The operator controls the robot by moving the leader arm situated at the operator station, whose motions are mimicked by an identical follower arm mounted on top of the animal quadruped robot. This leader-follower arm control interface enables fast and intuitive teleoperation, as it provides direct feedback for the current joint pose configuration to the operator. Its implementation is also simple and reliable, as the follower arm simply tracks the leader arm pose in joint space, with no need for forward or inverse kinematics computations. During manipulation, the operator relies primarily on the video feeds from two cameras mounted on the wrist at different angles for visual feedback. For the navigation task, teams raced their robots to traverse over all six waypoints marked with red crosses on the ground without any collisions with the environment. During locomotion, the operator relies on the NV Block's 3D reconstruction of the environment obtained by fusing data from the onboard stereo cameras, as well as the raw video feed from a camera mounted on a boom, both providing a third-person view of the robot. During the cabinet inspection task, a closed cabinet needed to be opened, such that a container inside the cabinet can be picked up and placed on a designated position. In addition to the leader-follower interface for controlling arm motions, a game controller is also used to command walking, opening, and closing the gripper, and also for commanding highly precise arm motions for tasks that require it. Here, the red container that was picked up needs to be placed on top of the green container on the staircase. The screw cleanup task involved picking up a screw on the ground and throwing it into the blue waste container. By moving the wrist to a downwards-facing direction, the wrist-mounted camera can be used to search for the small screw, which would otherwise be difficult to detect since its exact location on the ground is not predefined. Although unrelated to industrial inspection, the buzz wire task was designed to test the fine manipulation capabilities of the teleoperated robot. Here, the robot must grasp the metal ring and manipulate it around the bent wire such that no contact is made between the ring and the wire. We use the leader-follower arm control interface when the arm is stretched, as well as the game controller, which enables finer control of the gripper along a single axis of motion. For the bottle filling task, the robot was required to pick up a bottle from a table, open it, pump water into it, and close the lid back on. We 3D printed a custom-designed bottle holder, which enables securing the bottle for a task that typically requires two arms for a human to perform. Although screwing and unscrewing a twist cap is an easy task for humans, it is difficult for robots, which typically have limited force and tactile sensing capabilities as compared to humans. During the competition, we experienced some network connection issues, which caused us to drop the bottle and not have enough time left to pump water into it. Nonetheless, we were able to recover by picking the bottle back from the ground and have just enough time left to successfully screw the cap back into the bottle to receive partial points.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Time's up.
Yeah, I think it's closed.
So, applause for the robot and the operator.